Hi guys, this is Himanshu and in this video I will be discussing the solution of problem counting divisors. So basically the problem says that you are given an array of n integer and for each integer you have to print its number of divisors. So basically this is a beginner level problem, but I have seen many hard level which requires the solution which I will discuss as a pre-processing step, and I have seen such problem in placement tests of few companies too. Okay, and one more thing, this problem can be modified a little bit. I will be discussing this modification at the end of the video. So for this problem, I will be discussing three approaches. One naive approach, which will be of time complexity O n into x. And a better approach with the time complexity of O n into root x. And the last approach will have a time complexity of x log x for pre-processing. And for each query, it will have a time complexity constant. So let us see these approaches. So first let's see naive approach. So since the problem asks us to count the number of divisor of a certain integer, what we can simply do is to iterate from 1 to x. So we can traverse from 1 to x and check whether x is divisible by I or not. If x is divisible by I, we will simply increment the answer. Now since we have to do this for n integer, the total time complexity will be O of n into x. With this approach, our solution will exceed the time limit. And for beginners, if you are wondering how can we check whether our solution will be accepted in the given time limit or not, so there is a simple approximation for that, and that approximation is, if this thing under big O of notation evaluates to approximate 10 to the power 8, then our solution will get accepted with the time limit of 1 second in most of the coding platforms. So what I mean by that is, suppose n is given 10 to the power 5 and x is given 10 to the power 6, and our time complexity is n into x, which will be 10 to the power 5 into 10 to the power 6 equals to 10 to the power 11. So according to our assumption, it will not pass. Now let us discuss a better approach. We can make an observation here, and that observation is, for every I which divides x, its another divisor will be x by I. That is, suppose if x is 6 and I is 2, its one divisor will be 2 and another divisor will be 3. So we can reduce the end limit of our loop, because for every I its counterpart will be x by I. Now we can see every divisor comes with a pair. Let's say for example 12, 1 and 12 are in pair, 2 and 6 are in pair, and 3 and 4 are in pair. So if we traverse using this simple loop, after 3, our pairs will get repeated. So we have to find the maximum value after which our pair will start get repeating. So that maximum value will be root of x. So now why this will be root of x? I will leave you to think about this. Now, so our modification will become like this. We will traverse from 1 to root x, and for each I, we will check if x is divisible by I or not. If it is divisible by I, we will increment answer by 2 this time for every pair. Now we have to take care of one condition here, where we will have to increase answer by 1 only. So I will leave this to you to think about that condition, and you can tell us in comment. And what will be the time complexity of this? We have to do this for n integers, so time complexity will be O of n root x. Now let us check whether this will pass or not. So n is 10 to the power 5 and root x will be 10 to the power 3. So it will evaluate to 10 to the power 8. So this approach might get accepted. But why settle for less if we can do better? So now I will tell you approach with the time complexity of O x log x for pre-processing, and for each of the n query, the answer will be given in constant time complexity. Now, instead of calculating answer per query, what we will do is we will store the answer, that is count of divisors for each possible value of x beforehand. And then for each query, we will simply print that value. So now let's see how can we calculate the answer beforehand. So what are the possible values of x according to the constraint? It is from 1 to 10 to power 6. So until now, what we were doing is we were looking for the divisors. But this time, instead of looking for divisor, we will look for the multiple of each number. And for each multiple, we will increase its divisor count by 1. So what I mean by that is suppose for 2, we have its multiple as 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and so on. And that each multiple will have 2 as its divisor. So their divisor count will be incremented by 1. So basically what I mean by that is we will simply iterate from 1 to 10 to power 6. And for each I, we will look its multiple. So we will do something like this. We will start from I, then its next multiple will be 2i. Again, its next multiple will be 3i, and so on. So for each multiple, we will increment its divisor count by 1. So what we are doing is, let us see a running example. Suppose our range was 6. So first we will increment the multiple of 1. Then for each multiple of 2, we will increment its count. Then for 3, we will increase the count of its multiple. And this way, we will have count of divisors for each number. Now, what will be the time complexity of this approach? Now, for some, at a glance, the time complexity might look like O of x squared, because each loop is running till x. But let's see, is it really O of x squared? So for I equals to 1, this loop will run for x times. And for I equals to 2, this will run for x by 2 times. Similarly for 3, it will run x by 3 times. Until 1, which is x by x time. Now what will be the sum of this? It will be equal to till 1 by x. Now what is the sum of this value? It is approximately equals to log x. And why it is log x? Basically we can write this like this. x1, 2, and let's say. Now this sum can be replaced by integral from 1 to n 1 by x. So integration of 1 by x is equal to log x. It is basically ln x. From 1 to n, which will be ln of n. I will be writing ln as log of n minus log of 1, which will be 0. So this thing is approximately same as log x. So our time complexity will be of O of x log x. And other things. Now this problem requires us to count the number of divisor for each x. Now this problem can be modified like, instead of calculating the count of each divisor, we might be asked to count the sum of each divisor, or we might be asked to get the smallest divisor of each number or the largest divisor of each number. I hope you will be able to convert the solution according to those modifications. And for implementation part, I will be showing you implementation in next video, but I will recommend you to try to implement this first yourself. And if you are able to do so, then good for you. Otherwise, you can watch my next video.